Everybody, welcome to today's literacy lesson. We're going to be continuing reading room 13 today. Please make sure that you have something to draw with today. We're going to be doing a little bit of reading and then some drawing linked to that. Okay, everybody, so it's really important that you have read up to the chapters and followed the story so far. Otherwise, chapter 6 may be seem a little bit confusing. Please make sure that if you haven't, you go back and make sure the lessons are done from previous lessons where we have read up to the end of chapter 5. Today you're going to be reading chapter 6. I'm going to be popping it on the screen in a minute, so it'll be coming up on the video. If that's a little bit difficult to read, it will also be attached to the seesaw activity. After you've read it, we're going to be doing a task linked to it where you'll need to look back at the text to help you. Right, everybody, so your task today is to use the text to really carefully draw a picture of the view from the girls' hotel window. This is described really well by Robert Swindells, the author, on page 32, which is the third page of chapter 6. After you've drawn it, I'd love you to colour it, but I'd also like you to label it with information from the text. So for example, if you've put a tombstone that's been inscribed, you've drawn one, then I'd like you to draw an arrow to it with the text that says that, which, you know, gives you the reason that you wanted to draw that. I'm looking for some really, really accurate drawings using the text. Remember that we're looking at the view from the hotel window, so that is outside of the hotel. Please upload your images to Seesaw. Hopefully you've managed to colour them and label them as well. I'll be looking forward to seeing them. The trick is, if you've done this really accurately, then yours and somebody else's in the class should be quite similar, or at least include many of the same things.